think teachers. Tapos more on books and yung simple facilities like chairs. Kasi I've observed in elementary schools, as in sobrang crowded. Eh, di lang pala chairs, classroom. Yung basic necessities muna.
Dapat pong ano, taasan yung budget para sa mga public schools. Kasi sa ngayon po nakikita ko na ang dami ng mahihirap na hindi nakapag-aral. So tingin ko yun talaga yung kailangan sa panahon ngayon.
Welcome back. Our question, what do you think is the most important reform needed by our education system? From Donald of Pandan Antique. Philippine basic education is experiencing the same problem every year. Shortage of classrooms, teacher and support from the government. We need more teachers and facilities to help basic education. More teacher trainings. From Rose Ramos of Santiago City. Noticeably, most teachers cannot speak straight English. Hence, we can't expect them to teach their students right grammar. Government must take, I can't even speak anymore, must take steps to teach teachers English grammar. Then everything follows instead of adding 2 years to high school. Poor quality of education, mainly caused by incompetent teachers. From Cez Montejo, okay. Budget reform to make all the positive changes possible. From Marcelo, the blame should not be laid entirely on the feet of the teachers. For this, the high ratio of students per teacher hampers the learning process. Add to that the lack of classrooms, and we have a disaster waiting to happen. Although the purpose of K to 12 sounds good in theory, however, I still have doubts if this will solve the problem given the present system. Wow, thank you for all of your comments. From Leo Pruna of Paniki in Tarlac, the K plus 12 program is the best as it addresses the chronic problems of the education system. From Ray Tagala of Gensan, Philippine education experiences the same problem time and time again. Yet the department hasn't addressed any of these. Lack of classrooms and teachers, these problems surfaced every year, yet the different Deped secretaries do not have a political will to solve them. From Rona Gavino, schools are also a business, yes. Why deny their profits, especially if they are introducing improvements to their schools? Einstein, that's the question for you. Okay, reform. What is the best education reform that you, as a student leader and as someone graduating this year, that must be managed and implemented?
One, we should strengthen higher we should strengthen public education by allocating higher state subsidy on it. Yung problema naman ho sa classrooms, sa teachers, yung kakulangan natin sa upuan at sa mga libro ay masusolusyunan kung maganda ang matama yung inilalaan na budget ng ating government. The recommendation of UNESCO ay 6% of the gross domestic product should be allocated to education. Tayo po 3% lang po yung ina-allocate natin. At tingin po natin kahit pa po magandang pakinggan yung K-12 na program, pero kahit dagdagan mo po ng isang dekada yung ating education system, kung isang dekada ho nang walang libro, walang maayos na upuan, classroom yung ating mga estudyante, eh, baliwala rin po. Pangalawa po ay yung sa ating curriculum. Mm-hmm. Yung ating pong education ay naka-framework on how to support the demands of the world market instead of supporting our own needs here in the country. Lagi po naka-framework yung ating education kung ano yung hindi yung kung ano yung pangailangan. Tama po yung comment kanina eh, na ang yung business, yung economic activity po ng bansa ay majority agriculture in nature eh. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi po tayo nagpo-produce ng mga agriculturist, farmers. Mm-hmm. Hindi na ho na-encourage
sexy yung ating farmer ngayon, sexy
yung ating mga kabataan.
Okay, Julia, ikaw naman.
Sa akin kasi, ma'am, it's really true that we need reforms. And one, for me, educator's view, mas madami dapat na seminars which will really be helping teachers in dealing with the changes that comes. And I guess let's not put all the blame in DepEd. We as teachers kasi should also learn how to improve all the things that we ourselves are doing, like we are already loaning, why not loan for something that will be useful to students and it will be for our own gain.
Okay.
Rather than complaining and complaining.
Emma,
I just want to react on a comment. a while ago, putting blame on teachers, English. Actually, it is not only English, no, that it is not the sole factor for this deteriorating quality education.
Yeah. They can't even teach us Filipino.
Yeah. On our part, we really see the effort of the Department of Education, the determination actually of the secretary himself in pushing this K-12. Mm-hmm. They have this good idea, intention, but then again, we need not to forget the backlogs, the shortages, that is, we really consider the, maybe not the main factor, but the biggest factor, factor here, that's why the quality of education is deteriorating.
Okay. Mm. And Jess?
Well, I think, number one, there has to be a paradigm shift, no? Mm-mm. And thinking out of the box solutions to frequent problems. For example, the use
they said in most of the tweets and the annoys,
for example, the use of
the
technology.
Same problems.
The use of technology. We can solve some of the instructional materials problem using technology. Right now, the department is having this program right now. We have piloted this in three regions called Learning Resource Materials Development Centers. Mm-hmm. It's a portal where you check in, upload some of the materials developed by the teachers, no? And then the teachers in other areas can access it.
If they have computers,
well,
where they
that's
are.
The reason why we are augmenting our computerization program.
You know, why don't you take over internet cafes?
We are
and transform it into a learning hub rather than just downloading all of the games. I mean, rent, if a school is near an internet cafe and the students spend most of the time, mm-hmm. cannot the Deped or the school, I mean, it's a crazy idea, but
that's
the hardware and the software can be used there. And the name setup, you don't have to set it up in your own backyard.
That's true, Mom, it's not really a crazy idea. I think it's a wonderful idea. And that's the reason why we are trying to coordinate with the Department of Interior and Local Government and the business community. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga, kung may internet cafe doon, why don't we just use it?
Yeah. That will be their audiovisual room. If
that,
you can't that, build it in
that
the
will
school,
be their corporate
we will all walk to the internet cafe and and give money to this entrepreneur.
That right? will be part of their corporate social responsibility.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Plus the other reform, aside from the K-12 that we're implementing right now, it's really this idea of community. The Department of Education or the government itself cannot just solve the problem in one shot. No, it requires the cooperation of all members of the society, even the private sector, even the civil society groups, even the students. That's the reason why, you know, this Bigada Eskwela, the whole idea is really community partnership. We need to bring back that bayanihan spirit. We used to have that. Mm-hmm. Somehow it got lost now. That's why we want to bring that positive value of the Filipino called bayanihan spirit. And I think if we can be able to do that, we would be able to solve half of the problem.
And you need not increase the budget of the Deped?
Well, we still need to increase the budget. But then again, the budget can only be increased if revenues are there, meaning taxes are paid accurately, and taxes are used for budget. Mm-mm.
But you mentioned about, if you still have time, the increase in the state subsidy for public schools from elementary until tertiary. What is the level of support? How many public schools, colleges, and universities do we have in relation to the private tertiary schools?
Well, tertiary education is highly dominated by private schools.
Private schools. So just
out of the 1,726 higher educational institutions, 88% of it ay private.
Private.
No? So 111 lang po ang state universities and colleges.
Mm-hmm. And these are, when you say state colleges and universities, it's the Philippine state.
Yes.
It's not the
yes.
local government.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
That's running it.
Yes.
Oh, is there an effort? Is there some kind of a signal being given to you by legislators that there should be some improvement
in the number of state support for subsidies to higher education?
Well, based on the program of CHED, gusto nila mambawasan pa yung mga state universities.
Ah, because naman, non-performing universities naman to, or already introduced, or still doing courses that have already had
like, may mga ilan-ilan, ma'am, na sumusuportang mga legislators na para dagdagan yung budget. Pero still, manggagaling naman sa DBM, sa Aquino administration ng proposal kung gusto nilang taasan ng budget.
Okay. Thank you very much. I know you've been very busy for the whole day, and I'm happy that you don't have a lot of problems and you've been able to see what the problem areas are. But
thank you.
It's the content and it's the sustainability of your efforts at introducing K to 12 or K plus 12.
It's K to 12.
K to 12 in the educational system of the public schools, no? And then thank you very much also, Emma, for joining us, and Julia and Einstein, good luck to you. That's all the time we have. Talk to us again next week on Talkback.